We sign ourselves with the sign of the cross and pray, we adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Psalm 41, Reaching Out in Love. Blessed are those who reach out to others in love, who give generously to those in need. God smiles on them and sustains them in their times of trouble.
I realize, I pray, O God, I have done some of that, but not enough.
But you have sustained me in my troubles anyway. When I was sick and afraid, when I was overwhelmed by problems, when the people I cared for turned against me, you helped me out of that mess. Your invisible hand guided me.
And now, another chance to reach out to others in love, to give generously to those in need. When trouble comes again, I will have your support. Blessed be your holy name.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Jeremiah, chapter 17, verses 5 and 6. Thus says the Lord, cursed is the man who trusts in human beings, who seeks his strength in flesh, whose heart turns away from the Lord. He is like a barren bush in the desert that enjoys no change of season, but stands in a lava waste, a salt and empty earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Wow. This excerpt from Jeremiah provides such a vivid image of a life turned away from God, a barren bush, lifeless, not generating new life. The desert, dry, hot, empty, unchanging, no transformation, no opportunity for growth. And then my favorite part, those whose hearts turn away from the Lord stand in a lava waste. Now that's like a scene from Jurassic Park or Star Wars or something, right? When you were a kid, did you ever pretend certain parts of the ground were lava and have to tiptoe or dash around them to remain on the non-lava parts? I know I sure did. And guess what? The kids these days still do it too. While walking with a kiddo to the speech room, he called out, "Wait! There's Wabba!" I was like, "What?" He started skipping around the purple linoleum tiles on the floor, and then it all made sense to me. Oh, lava. And guess what? I was standing on a purple tile. He was like, "Hurry! Hurry! Get out of the Wabba! You burning!" And while in the middle of the hallway, I quickly heeded his warning and dashed over to the white tiles, which were safe. And then I dramatically exclaimed, "Phew, that was a close one. Good thing I'm wearing my invisible lava-proof boots." He looked at me with wide eyes, but without missing a beat, he answered, "My Wabba boots at home." I couldn't help but reflect on this moment with this preschooler as I pondered this passage. When our hearts are turned away from the Lord, focused on things of the world and perhaps drawing us to sin, we find ourselves in lava. But the beautiful thing is, with God's help and the grace of the sacrament of reconciliation, we are equipped with our invisible lava-proof boots. that even when we do inevitably find ourselves in lava, the desert, a barren bush, we have a way back to God, a return to the state of grace and life with the Lord that we're called to. This is a particular focus during our season of Lent, our annual journey of renewed conversion in Christ and the promise of his resurrection. So, as you go about your day today, perhaps ponder, where are the volcanoes in your life pouring out the lava? These volcanoes can be temptations of the world that turn us away from the Lord, that lead us to sin. We all have them, right? And where do you find yourself in close proximity to the lava? Are you wearing your lava-proof boots, or did you leave them somewhere else? Did you tiptoe around the lava and avoid it altogether? Is there someone else leading you out of the lava and guiding you to safety, accompanying you to the Lord? As we continue our Lenten journey, let us turn our hearts to the Lord and stay out of the lava.
For the strength that we need to return to the Lord, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Abide with your servants, O Lord, who implore the help of your grace, that we may receive from you the support and the guidance that we need to accomplish your will through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us conclude our prayer today with the Mary Prayer.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Beneath your compassion, hear our petitions, and rescue us from all temptation. O glorious and blessed Virgin Mary. Amen.
Beloved of God, thanks so much for joining us in prayer today. Do take good care of yourself and one another, and we'll see you tomorrow for Concert Friday.